If you have been watching MrBeast for a while, then you probably noticed the smooth win and out transition that he uses all the time. So let's recreate them in Premiere Pro. First of all, we need to create an adjustment layer. So go to the project panel, click on new item, and then adjustment layer. Then click OK. Now drag the adjustment layer above the two clips in the timeline. If you want, you can shorten the adjustment layer. Now let's add some effects. So go to the effects panel and search transform, and apply it to the adjustment layer in the timeline. Now make sure the adjustment layer is selected. Then go to effects controls and move your player to the start of the clip. Now for this transition to work perfectly, we need to zoom in a bit. We can do this by keyframing scale to create a starting keyframe, then move forward a bit and then zoom in by changing the scale value. We have now created a simple zoom in effect, but we still need to add motion blur. So uncheck choose composition shutter angle, then change the shutter angle to 360. If you now play back the video, you can see that the zoom is really slow and not smooth. We can change this by highlighting both keyframes, then right click on one of them, move to ease in and then ease out. This animation is now smooth, but we still need to make the animation speed up gradually to get the real nice zoom effect. We can do this by expanding the arrow next to scale to open the velocity settings. If we now zoom in a bit, we can see the speed graph. When clicking on the keyframe, we get these handles that we can use to change the speed of the animation. And since we are zooming in, we want it to be slow in the beginning and then speeding up as the time goes. So drag both handles all the way to the right, so we get this peak at the second keyframe, or simply this gradually speeding up ramp. We've now created the first part of the zoom in effect. Now position your player on the second keyframe and then make a cut. Now select the second part of the adjustment layer and delete the transform effect. Then go to the effects panel and search replicate and apply the effect to the second part of the adjustment layer. Now in effects controls, change the count value to 3. Now don't worry if it looks weird like this, we're gonna change it now. So search mirror in the effects panel and apply it to the second part of the adjustment layer. But do this 4 times so we get 4 mirror effects. We can do this by making sure that the second adjustment layer is selected and then double clicking on the effect. We should now have 4 mirror effects in the effects panel. So go to the first mirror and change the reflection to center value so we get this seamless border in between the clips. Now go to the second mirror effect and change the reflection angle to 90 degrees. Now change the second position value so we get the seamless border again. On the next mirror, change the reflection angle to 180. And don't worry if the screen gets black. Simply change the first reflection center value until you get this border again. On the last mirror, change the angle to 270 and change the second reflection value. We now get this one big picture that we can use when zooming in. So let's add a zoom effect. So go to the effects panel and search transform and apply the effect to the current adjustment layer. We now have to zoom in the big picture that we just created. So simply keyframe scale and make sure that you're at the start of the clip, then move forward a bit and change the scale value to 300. We can now see that we no longer have the one big picture and instead a normal clip. That's because we just created a zoom. And don't forget to add motion blur to the zoom by unchecking the box and changing the shutter angle. We have now almost created the entire zoom in effect, but if you play back the video clip, you can see that the zoom in is way too slow. So highlight the both keyframes on the second adjustment layer, then right click ease in and then ease out them. We now need to change the velocity settings again, so click on arrow next to scale and zoom into the keyframes. But before we change anything, if you go through the video, we can see that during the second adjustment layer that it goes really slow in the beginning. But we can change that by dragging both handles all the way to the left. It's the exact opposite on what we did on the first adjustment layer. As you can see, we created a really nice zoom in transition. But we still need to reposition the adjustment layer so it transitions between both clips. So drag the second adjustment layer to the right side of the cut and the first adjustment layer to the left side of the cut. We have now created the zoom in transition. Now let's do the zoom out transition. To make the zoom out transition, the first and second adjustment layer need to switch places. Once done correctly, you should have the adjustment layer with all the mirror effects in the start of the timeline. Now scroll down to the transform tab and switch the position of both keyframes. Because we're zooming out, we want to be slow in the beginning and then fast in the cut. So simply drag both handles all the way to the right, so you get this sort of peak at the second keyframe. It's the exact same thing that we did in the zoom in transition. Now go to the second keyframe and make a cut in your adjustment layer. Now delete the adjustment layer with no keyframes on, then position the adjustment layer next to each other again. Now select the adjustment layer to the right and then switch places of both keyframes as we did earlier. Now in the velocity settings, make sure to drag both handles all the way to the left so you get the peak at the first keyframe. We have now successfully created a zoom out transition. Because we did the effect on adjustment layers, we can easily switch out the clip with other ones and it will work perfectly fine. If you found this video helpful, then please subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.